star sky. Not with my earth eyes, with my brain fire that is itself a star. Deep light spears fascinate from suns and stars, and dark blue space dancing through high mountain air. I rose a light cloud of no particular shape toward the sky home above green earth mountains and the cities, rock frozen, flesh frozen. And suddenly it was all white light. They came from the white light to me in the white light. They messaged my lives to me at the paths I had walked and could walk. They messaged love in rainbows and dark music, light shattering sky foam like space soap. The sky was orange and deep blue, the mountains were beneath. Flesh people often call them saints and devils and gods. I call them friends. They messaged voices and tastes and smells and images and worlds and words and screeching sounds and the songs and the great winds and the sea, our brothers and sisters. Coming back into the flesh place is like walking through a roar, devouring electric teeth, wind tumbling, egg metering, vortexing, and the stars whirl down and the yellow light and white light make whirling rainbows that turn gray and cloudy, even almost smoky in night bed darkness. And my flesh place, the body, is below me. I take its shape. I become its shape. I pretend dreams and create plots and people them with problems and confusions, intrusions, conflicts, resolutions. It all becomes very intense and totally significant beyond words as I experience it and wake up reluctantly at 5:30 in the a.m. to some talk show on the radio, exchanging make wrongs and playing Ain't It Awful and blaming Nixon, Ford, Uncle Ho, Mao, Castro, religion, no religion, with no viable solution or taking a responsibility evidence. It's so sane in the white light. They message so much. I message so much. Back here in the flesh place, in the meathead brain that aches, I hear the beta body chattering, trying to give my soul significance and label it, making it supermarket available and palpable, even palatable. Weird, wired make-wrongers on the radio cranking out hanged man's hope and despair for the flesh-placed fear junkies driving cars with smog chokers, complaining about pollution and natural resources dwindling and demanding at the same time the rights to drive around in cars that seat 2.5, burn petrol like it will always be there, and 400 horse engines on oversized tires, all of which takes about 12 tons of the finest Appalachian coal or its equivalent for a unit to build and can set the wheel over the river. In contrast to all the others that I'm used to. When I stop worrying, I remember and forget where I put my glasses the night before and cuss around the house, waking the others and allowing them to think that being human isn't only. Flesh is inconvenience. Too much convenience is supposed to be boring. Anyhow, a lot of us are junkied on being here time and time again. It takes little wandering around and listening, even less reading, even less standing and watching to see how many people who never think to ask out loud put reasons here for us to get stuck here. Here in the flesh, they keep you at any rate by fascinating you with contrasts such as amusement and boredom, and the sensory differentiation between experiences which you get to label painful and pleasurable, and find others who agree and disagree with you on exactly what is painful and pleasurable, all of which gives you opportunities to confuse the painful with the pleasurable and make life tastes which taste the same or as different as somebody else. And you get to make friends and enemies, breaking up the texture of the white light into egos and nations, states and cities, football teams and people who drive cars, and people who beg carrying their children in wheelbarrows on their backs. For whom you have a variety of options about how to feel, somewhere between something they call here guilt, something else they call contempt, something else they call sorrow, something a bit more they call caring, and something a bit will be opposite of that they call not caring. Sometimes you even get to think that your brain understands it. What really makes it entangling is when what you think is your understanding in the brain makes you talk and act in a way that pleases you and makes others give you agreement. Then you get to think you're winning and you really have a beat, and you may be in a life form in something they call here a country, in and something else they think is real and label a time, like a year after the guest at death and return of someone they refer to most often unconsciously as the personification of the Christ and call it 1976. And the country might be something called by general agreement of a language which is split from other babblings of the alike and come to be called English, the United States. You may even get to live in something else they in the flesh place call a city, and be given lots of agreement in the form they call being wealthy, and do some things they label the good life or the sweet life, and then not enjoy it. I return to the white light very often. I cannot message to you exactly in noises or the print that makes itself significant by agreement predicated upon the replication of noises with agreed upon significance. Messaging is something you cannot effort to remember how to do because you already know inside you and outside you how to do it. It takes falling into or jumping through, and it is delightful to do it and not get put into the place the flesh place fear junkies call the madhouse. Unless, of course, you're one of the ones who find delight in being a denizen and having sour and tidbit for the shocking thing. I suppose it would be of interest to you, my other being parts, who find delight in walking to and fro in the flesh place, gathering agreement harmony harvests instead of incarceration rule, to know how to message and stay free, as we here like to call it, you and I, and not get incarcerated. I shall create spaces and words for you to find for life dancing. Keeping the order of the confusion here is the game that keeps you free. The ones who get incarcerated are the ones who get stuck on seeing what they see and need to get the agreement of others that what they see there is as significant or more than what the flesh place has to offer. Some of these reach the madhouse because what they say is too logical, and some because what they say is too illogical. Give the flesh place fear junkies here space to create the feeling of having agreement by asset and image and nod and playing in the pastimes and earning your daily foodstuffs and looking respectable. If you want to walk back and forth in the flesh place, this is keeping the order of the confusion. The more agreement you desire in the flesh place, the more you will have to make your assets, images, and nods give those trapped here kinds of assistance they can accept at once. When you put this into practice, you can walk to and fro in all worlds and take the messagings from the white light to make rainbows of possibilities for those here.